Well,
here's the thing. And I'm jealous of you, more impressed that I should say, jealous, because in the summers at SNL, I would never do anything. I would just take it off.
Yeah.
And I'm so impressed that you wrote this film and you directed it over the course of the summer, and it's beautiful. And obviously, this is an autobiographical film about your mother and spending time with her before she passed away.
Yeah.
And it's very funny, but it's a drama. It must be completely different writing this than what you do for your day job.
Yeah, it was weird. But when I wrote it, I had no intention of, like, this is going to be, like, a movie that gets made. I just wanted to kind of try to flex a different muscle or see if I could write something that was a little more tonally different. Or, like, you know, at SNL, or I also have written for, like, Broad City and stuff. They're just hard comedies, and I was just curious of, like, what it would feel like to try to write something that was a little more dramatic. And then the fact that it actually got made was, like, such a surprise. I'm like, great, you know? But, yeah, and it is a drama, but then I also, like Molly, you had said, I wanted to cast a lot of comedy people in it, too, so that it wasn't just, like, drama nonstop. You know what I mean? That it wasn't, like, a slog.
And I have to imagine, because of how personal a film this was, the most important part was casting your mother. And I know Molly was your first choice. And is it true, Molly, that when you guys first met, you invited Chris to a taco party?
I did. I had a taco party at my house.
That's right.
Now, was that a taco party you were already having and then you invited Chris? Or was you were like, oh, you met Chris and said, I got to throw this guy a taco party?
I love it.
I was already having it. And I think
it was one of her famous taco parties.
Yes. It is a famous taco party. But I did invite you. And didn't you like that there were, like, kids running around?
Yeah, it was just nice. I don't know. This
family.
Is so, like, cheesy, but I, like, truly, like, you know, the movie's autobiographical, but it's not 100% true. And so it's like, I don't, like, when I watch the movie, I'm not like, that's exactly my sister or that's exactly my dad. But, you know, the role of my mother I really cared about. And so I do see my mom up there, and I wanted to. And so when I went to this taco party, everyone was, like, so nice and was like, oh, my God, Molly's going to be great in the movie. She's so talented. But they were like, aside from being talented, which she is, she's, like, the nicest person you will ever meet. And I truly, like, was in the car on the way, like, back from the taco party. And I called my sisters, and I was like, I think the woman who plays our mom is going to be very nice. I'm so... I like both of my stories ended with me crying.
I almost always cry after taco parties as well, but it's always, I ate too many tacos. So the pop brownie scene we saw coming into this. That must have just been so much fun to shoot. Was that super scripted, or was that...
No, it was great, because it was... There were definitely days where you'd look at the call sheet and be like, ooh, this is going to be a sad one all day long.
Yeah.
And then there were some days where you'd be like, okay, great, this is the scene where Molly's tried medical marijuana for the first time. This will be fun. And it was like watching a one-woman show. It was so fun. And she was... The whole crew, you could tell, was just, like, so excited to just, like, kind of sit back and relax and just, like, watch what she would do. And it was weird. We were talking about this earlier, but, like, it's based on a real thing. Like, my mom is, like, a wonderful but, like, conservative woman. She had never tried drugs. She would never dare to try drugs, or at least that she would. What she would tell us. And I was in New York at the time in the real version of it, so I wasn't there. And she was home with my dad and my sisters, and she called me, and she was like, Chris, I'm going to do drugs. She didn't, like, want to do medical marijuana, but she, like, you know, she was like, I'm going to do it, and she was so confident. And so she called and left me a voicemail being like, your mom's a badass, and now she's about to take drugs. And I was like, and I got the voicemail, and I was like, I wonder how that will go. And then I went underground to do some UCB shows all night, and I was underground for, like, hours. And then when I came back up, I had all these voicemails from my mom, and I was like, what could have happened? And the voicemails were like, here we go. And then, like, number two was like, I don't feel a thing. Drugs have nothing on me. And then the third one was like, And then the fourth one was like, your dad isn't looking at anything. He's not looking at anything. Like, he's looking, but he's not. And then the fifth one was like, we may have to go to the emergency room. And it was so funny to just, like, have this, like, full narrative, like, displayed. And so then for the movie, I just took that and then put myself into it.
Yeah.
That's great.
Well, it's fantastic. Seriously, it's such an accomplishment for both of you. It's a beautiful film. Really, everyone, you must see it. It's fantastic. Molly Shannon and Chris Kelly, everybody.